lady and his supervisor. And the sketch you just saw was a picture of Louie the Ghost. So the new character popped in my head, so I drawn him with big antlers, like a deer. And the sketch just popped in my head, so I had in mind that I'd be the character. And I just come up with the sketches. So when the first movie came out, I won an animated contest. I was trying to work with puppets, and then I had an idea, and then I drew the sketch of Louie the Ghost, and the girl, evil monster, that monster that popped in my head. He just wants everything, he's smart, and he wants everything he wants, but he's smart elephant, you know. But Gerald is a smart elephant, and he kind of likes him, does everything he wants to. And his wife, Louie, so they married together, and each of them argue every day, and back talk every day. Well, I'm not talking about the personality. Only Rudolph. The owner of the Imagination Animation, he came up with the characters, so he drew it, and I was filling in the characters. So, Gerald was one of my first characters that popped in my head, and here, at my animation desk at the near of the movie image in Astoria, New York City, only Randall. Rudolph was there, and he came up with the characters, and she came back later at 12 o'clock p.m., and she gave me the sketches, and then I complimented her, and then I gave her the job for the creator job. She was a creator, and then she gave rough sketches with pencil, and then overfilled them with Sharpie. Overfilled them with, we always fill them with the wizardry pen, and then they filled it out, and then showed me her work, and then she got complimented, and then the owner of, and then she got hired by Tom Hanson, the previous owner, and then she got hired, and he got fired, and then he came up with a new sketch. With a new character, with the old character Gerald, and then we both Tom Hanson got rehired again. So at first, these rough sessions with pencil only filled with the Radio 945 PM. I used that to come up with a sketch of the new show, and it was finished out as a very good drawing with some Radio 945, and I used that to sketch with, and at first it looked a little bit like an ugly egg, and then it started out as a leaf, and it came out as a wonderful drawing. So I came up with that, and then I showed it to the other one, and then he was like, I like this guy. And then I had in mind that I'd do more characters in the future, like in 1970. I'd probably do it when 2017 was around. I'd do it when 2017 was around. And I am a young artist, I am the storyboard artist on the Toon Hickory Show, and also the storyboard supervisor on and the writer on the PJ Masks and the Muppet crossover movie by So we come up to catch it first, and someone over took over that name. So they come up to that. The PJ Masks and Muppet movie crossover. Muppet was our youth. So we did that, and then boom, we finally made a crossover movie. Now in the future, 2017, from this year to 2018, I'll still live on and create more characters for the movie. Thank you all for watching. And more characters will be coming on, and I will, and funding for this program, and the interviews, and the sponsors, and this some interviews sponsored by PHSGCA, the program, USA the Animals, and donate $100,000 to us. So we can donate to the ASPCA. We don't want animals to die and suffer like that. So we need $100,000 to donate $50 to us a day. And we really hate for animals to suffer like that. Animals are the really cutest thing. And like on the commercial, you'll see that every often, and we really don't want any of that to happen. So you need to donate $50 to us now, and we need to get up to the goal of $100,000 so we can donate to the ASPCA. Animals are really getting hurt, and we need to rescue them. And someone once told me, Ryan Hansen, supervising producer, he was saying that the commercial was bad, and he wanted me to come up with this idea first. So this was an idea I came up with. This was starting to get awkward, and then I found out that it was true. Animals need to survive. You need to save them by donating $50 to us so we can reach the goal of $100,000 and donate to the ASPCA. Just donate to us and have a good day, and we'll see y'all later. And one more thing. I've been also a puppeteer for about 32 years. Puppeteering. I've been puppeteering like that with Rod. I had my favorite Star Elmo puppet. A very long puppet here. I was a puppeteer performer for Elmo. And it was heart first. And one of the puppeteers, Lori Hansen, she came over here, and then she took me over to the control room. And then I held the puppet up like that and held Rod, and he was like, wow, I gotta hire you. And then she took me over to Steve Dalton, and he said, I don't know what the party is. And I was excited to get the job, and I love working with the Muppets. And I have done the animation, and I also done Catboy puppet with the Steve Dalton, worked with him. And he had arm sleeves that you could put in there. Sometimes he had rods, sometimes he had arm sleeves. We really can't decide that, so you have a good day.